Hundreds of thousands of pilgrims gathered today in Namgongo in commemoration of the bravery exhibited by the Uganda Martyrs. Among the dignitaries in attendance was the Minister of Justice and Constitutional Affairs, Norbert Mao, Deputy Speaker Thomas Tayebwa, the Prime Minister, Robina Nabanja, among others. President Yoweri Museveni and the First Lady Janet Museveni arrived at 9:50 a.m. to join in the celebration amid cheering crowds, while leading Mass under the theme, "But as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord." Joshua chapter 24 verse 15, Raphael Wokorach, the Bishop-elect of Nebbi Catholic Diocese, welcomed the pilgrims in and urged them to front unity as it has been during their pilgrimage.
God, through the celebration of today, is inviting us to the bigness of thinking, where we see the need to live according to the designs of God and to be like Joshua, who declared that me and my household, we shall serve the Lord.
Today marks 60 years since the Uganda Martyrs were declared saints by the Pope, making this celebration different. The Chairperson Organizing Committee, Catherine Mavengina, thanked President Museveni for the contribution of 1.5 billion shillings for the preparations and addition of 500 million shillings for construction of the altar. President Yoweri Museveni congratulated Christians upon reaching the Martyrs' Day. The President, however, emphasized the message, unity of purpose among believers opposed to division and sectarianism.
You remember we passed through many problems. We had Corona. We had Ebola, we had all those issues, but we managed to go through, and we are now here again. The young people say, vibing, is this vibing or what?
The President, however, emphasized the message of unity of purpose among believers, opposed to division and sectarianism. Museveni also urged Christians to work hard and get rid of poverty. He urged the Christians to the Uganda Martyrs, who he said stood for their morals and beliefs.
And Jesus said, if you only love your friends, how are you different from the pagans? Because they do the same. Jesus said, love your enemies. That's what Jesus taught us. This is the line of the NRM. Like on the issue of the homosexuals. They talk so much, this one, that one. They don't know that Uganda is a land of martyrs. If you want to play around, you play around with Uganda. You will see. You will not like it.
Region Catholics in their multitudes join in the Martyrs' Day celebrations at St. Denis Sebugwao Archdiocese Catholic Church in Imbale City, with the call for peace and unity in the region and country at large. Father William Ekapolok expressed concern over the rising insecurity and human rights abuses in the country and Elgon regions. He appealed to Christians and leaders to preach peace, foster unity in communities. Emyuka Director Rita Namwenge called upon Ugandans in the Elgon region to embrace government development programs in order to eradicate poverty in their households.
Love your neighbor as you love yourself.
NRM Chairperson Women League Lydia Wanyoto also used the same platform to encourage Christians to fight poverty and take their children to school and also embrace government programs.
So I would like to call upon all the mothers in Uganda, but more so in Imbale City, to make sure that we align ourselves to this thing, to serve our family, to love our spouses, to love our children and all members of our household.
Yeah.
Rescuers battled Monday to evacuate people from flood zones in southern Germany, as Chancellor Olaf Scholz said this was a warning that climate change was getting worse. Thousands of people in a number of regions had to leave their homes since torrential rain on Friday sparked deadly flooding. The floods have killed at least two, a volunteer rescuer and a woman who was found dead in the basement of a house. More evacuations were called overnight into Monday as the huge volumes of water caused flood defenses to fail. In Bavaria, some 800 people were asked to leave their homes in the area of Ebenhausenwerk after a dam burst early Monday. Residents around Marching Pichil in the area was affected by the floods were told to shelter in the upper floors of their homes. Rescuers on Monday found the body of a woman in the basement of her home, according to the local police. The 43-year-old is the second known victim of the floods, following the death of a volunteer fireman who was found dead on Sunday. The widespread flooding and continuous rainfall impacted transport in the region, with widespread train cancellations and delays.